Hello everyone. In this presentation, I am going to explain the basic concepts of dentine bonding agents. This presentation will be really helpful for dental students and also for practitioners to understand about bonding composite restorations to tooth. Let me start with a question. Let's consider that you have prepared a cavity for dental amalgam. When you are about to restore the cavity with amalgam, patient asks to restore it with a composite restoration instead of amalgam. Remember that the cavity was prepared for amalgam, so it has occlusal convergence, so the restoration could be mechanically retentive. Now, if you have to restore with composite, do you have to do etching and bonding? If you consider that bonding is to retain the restoration to tooth, here in this preparation, which is mechanically retentive, why should you need to bond? But in reality, bonding may help to retain the restoration to tooth, but mostly bonding is essential to minimize or to compensate and overcome polymerization shrinkage. So as long as composite contracts during polymerization, bonding is inevitable. Now let's go into little detail and let's see how this bonding concept evolved into dentistry. Let's magnify a portion of a cavity which is prepared for a composite restoration where the entire preparation is in enamel. Let's zoom in and we can now see the prepared cavity and the enamel in the bottom. In the early days, dentists and the researchers attempt to place composite restoration on top of the prepared enamel, but the restoration was weak and it was dislodging frequently with no inherent bonding between the composite and the enamel. A newer concept to retain the retention rate of composite with the enamel was introduced, in which an acid etchant is used to etch the cavity surface and then it is rinsed. Once the enamel surface is etched and rinsed, it creates micro irregularities in the surface of the enamel. And on top of this, the composite restoration was placed. This has improved the retention compared to that of the unetched enamel surface, but again, the composite which was placed on top was too viscous. So actually, inside the etched micro irregularities, the composite was not flowing inside, the bond strength is quite inefficient or it is inadequate. So researchers were thinking and this modification was made. What is it? The cavity preparation was done, then it was etched with acid so that the micro irregularities are made and then the resin is made into a less viscous or it is mixed with a solvent to make it into a very thin consistency. So this liquid resin is applied on the etched cavity surface which has irregularities and now this less viscous resin flows inside all those irregular areas and on top of that a composite restoration is placed. Now the liquid resin has gone inside the micro irregularities and have created a hydrophobic surface and the composite that we are placing on top of that is going to bond with the resinous liquid which is applied after etching. And with enamel, this is wonderful and a very good bond strength was achieved by doing this procedure. The same procedure was attempted even for dentine, but it all ended up in a big failure. For that, we have to understand the microstructure of the dentine, which is different from that of enamel. Let's consider that this is a cavity preparation which is made in dentine and let's magnify a small portion of the prepared cavity where we can see the floor which is made in dentine. If you magnify it, we can see the hydroxyapatite crystals and the collagen fibers. The microstructure of the dentine consists of hydroxyapatite crystals of around 65% and the organic content including collagen fibers and water for around 35%. If we are etching this surface and if you are attempting to place composite restoration on top of that, the bonding is poor. Dentine is rich in water and composite is a plastic material which hates water. And how come it is possible to create a bond between the water-rich dentine and the water-hating composite restoration? There comes the introduction of newer material called as the amphiphilic resins. What are these amphiphilic resins? These amphiphilic resins will have two ends. One end is hydrophilic and the other end is hydrophobic. This hydrophilic means it likes water and hydrophobic means it hates water. So both these ends are present in a single material called as the amphiphilic resins. So in the etched tooth surface, if you are applying this amphiphilic resin, especially onto the surface of the dentine, the hydrophilic ends will bond to that of the water-rich dentine and the hydrophobic ends will be free. And once we place composite on top of this, this hydrophobic ends will bond to the composite, which is hydrophobic. The amphiphilic resins we call in simple term as a primer. So all the primers that is used in dentistry are amphiphilic resin materials. And now the procedure is much more simplified. What you are going to do in case of dentine, after etching, you apply this amphiphilic resin and on top of that you can apply the bonding agent or the adhesive that we used with the enamel bonding, and on top of that we can do a composite restoration. So in order to simplify that, we can consider that the dentine bonding agent is now available in three steps. First, we have to etch with phosphoric acid, then we have to rinse it with water, then we have to apply the primer, which is the amphiphilic resin, which will bond to the dentine and the free hydrophobic end will be available, and then we have to apply an adhesive, which is a liquid resin like a bis GMA in a liquid consistency, which is totally hydrophobic, and that have to be applied on top of that primer. Then on top of that we can place the composite restoration. This is called as the fourth generation bonding agent. So fourth generation bonding agent is one of the wonderful bonding agent ever made in dentistry. Even though there are 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and so many innumerous number of generations of bonding agents which were introduced, this fourth generation bonding agent are three step etch and rinse bonding system is considered to be one of the best or gold standard system to which all other bonding systems are compared. It is a very good bonding system, but it has some inherent difficulties. One, it is more time consuming. Between the steps, there are multiple steps involved. If there is a contamination, then the bond strength is going to be very weak, and there is occurrence of post-restorative sensitivity. In order to overcome this, the fifth generation bonding agents were introduced. Here, etching is done, then it is rinsed with water. After rinsing with water, the primer and adhesive are mixed in the same bottle. The primer and adhesive are mixed into a single bottle and it is applied as a single layer. So now the three step have become two step of the etching as one step and the priming and adhesive as single step. This is called as the two steps etch and rinse bonding system. And this is also a wonderful bonding system, and it also provides an equivalent bond strength compared to that of fourth generation bonding system. Now the time consumption have been reduced, but the chances for contamination is still there and the post-treatment sensitivity still remained. Understanding this, why there is post-treatment sensitivity? Now we can understand that these all are etch and rinse system, that is the fourth generation and fifth generation are called the etch and rinse system. Why? Because we are applying an etchant, then we are rinsing it with water, then we are applying the primer and the adhesive. That is the etch and rinse system. This is also called as the total etch system. Why it is called as total etch system? Because it removes something called as the smear layer completely. What is the smear layer? The smear layer is when a tooth is prepared with a rotary cutting tool like a diamond point or a tungsten carbide burr in an air rotor, small powder particles of tooth is created, and this powder particles will be staying on the prepared cavity. This is called as the smear layer. This often goes inside the open dentinal tubules, forming something called as the smear plaques. And with the etch and rinse or the total etch system, this smear layer is completely removed. So the dentinal tubules are exposed. This could be one among the many reasons for occurrence of post-treatment sensitivity after doing a composite restoration. So the researchers were thinking about the alternatives. That includes the introduction of the mild acids instead of phosphoric acid for etching the dentine surface. Then the incomplete removal of smear layer is advocated. The smear layer can be modified instead of removing it. This all led to the introduction of self-etch bonding agents. So what are this self-etch bonding agent? Here, there is no need for etching separately. The etchant is also incorporated within the bonding agent. How come that is possible? Yes, now here, the primer, which was originally meant as an amphiphilic resin, which creates a bond between the water-rich dentine and the water-hating composite, that primer, which is made now into an acid. So the primer is made acidic, so the primer itself can etch the tooth surface and also prime the tooth surface. So now the primer has two jobs to do. One, it etches, and also it primes. So now the primer is called as an acidic primer. Now the bonding agent can be simplified into much simpler. Now there is no a separate step of etching. So the etching and priming is done by the same agent, which we call it as the acidic primer. And once that is done, we have to apply the second coat of the material called as the adhesive. And this is the sixth generation bonding agent, which is called as a self-etching bonding agent. So here, etching and priming is done with one bottle, and the adhesive is applied separately. And in the seventh generation, this adhesive is also added along with that acidic primer. Now, etching, priming, and adhesion is all happening with the application of a single coat of the material, and which is the seventh generation bonding agent. This is also a self-etching bonding system. So there are some inherent problems like the limited shelf life of this product. So in order to overcome that, the eighth generation bonding agent is available as two bottles, but one drop of the liquid from each of the bottle is mixed outside the oral cavity. Then it is applied on the prepared tooth. In the seventh generation, all the components are available inside a single bottle and it have to be taken and applied directly. But in the eighth generation, it is available in two bottles. It have to be mixed outside the oral cavity. Then it is taken and it is applied inside the prepared cavity. The chances for post-operative sensitivity has also reduced a lot compared to that of the etch and rinse systems. Even though everything is good with this bonding system, the bond strength is declined after 3 to 5 years of doing the restoration. This happens because of the deterioration of the collagen fibers, which is also involved in this bonding procedure. There are so many techniques which have been incorporated to overcome this, and one such bonding system which is recently introduced, which is called as the multimode or the universal adhesive. This multimode or the universal adhesive contains a genuine molecule called as 10-MDP. This 10-MDP was a patented material of curare. Recently, the patent got expired. Every other company have started making bonding agents and supplying it in the name of universal adhesive using this 10 MDP molecule. They are available in one-step and two-step systems. These universal adhesives are much better compared to that of the self-etching bonding systems. Now we can simplify and we can see that there are three different types of adhesive materials available. The fourth and fifth generations are called as the etch and rinse adhesive, where we use an etchant, rinse it with water, then we apply the primer and then we apply the adhesive, or together we will apply the primer and adhesive in fifth generation. Then the 6th, 7th and the 8th generation systems are called as the self-etch adhesive, where there is no separate etchant. The primer is made acidic and then we have to just apply and there is no rinsing procedure in this system. And then comes the multimode adhesive system, which can be considered as the 9th generation bonding agent. In the coming presentations, let's see about the role of the solvent in the bonding agent. There are different types of solvent like water, acetone, alcohol, which is added in the bonding agent. Let's see about the role and the importance of the solvent, because leaving the bottle of a bonding agent will lead to the evaporation of the solvent and deterioration of the bond strength. Let's see about that. In another presentation, let's see about the different generation of the bonding agents, especially the dentine bonding agents from the first generation till the latest generation. In another presentation, let's see about the steps in doing enamel and dentine adhesion, like selective etching, how to do the procedure for etch and rinse system, self-etch system, multimode system, and all those details. Then in a presentation, we can see about the self-etch adhesive, multimode adhesive, and in another presentation, let's see about the hybrid layer in a microscopic level. What will happen at a microscopic level after etching, after application of bonding agent, and all those details. Until then, have a nice day. Thank you for watching.